Hello, my name is Glenn Cummings, and this is the first of a series of demonstrations of writing code in Visual Basic. I call these prototypes because each one of these will demonstrate just a few features of Visual Basic in as simple a form as possible. The first example will be a program that transfers text from one text box to another text box using a transfer button. When you open Visual Studio, it looks something like this. This is Visual Studio 2012, and it will function pretty much the same way if you're using 2010. From this screen, we select New Project, and we're interested in the Visual Basic template, the Windows Form application, and we'll change the name from the generic Windows Application 1 to Prototype 1. Click OK. And Microsoft will build this form for you. It's quite a bit of code behind this, but we need to be concerned with that. This form has properties over here on the right, one of which is the text property, which currently says Form 1. We double click that, we can change it to Prototype 1. This is the text that appears here in the top gray bar of your form. We also have in our toolbox here several controls. We can drag these controls over to our form to make them more interesting. We'll be using two text boxes. There's one. Try that again. Text box one. And second text box here. And we also need a button, so we'll grab the button and drag that over. At this point, we actually have a working program. We can see that by clicking the Start button here. The first thing that Microsoft will do is to compile the code, and then it will run it. It sets up this little form here. There's the three controls that we've built. About the only thing that functions are these three buttons here at the top, should be fairly familiar. And we can close the form by clicking the Close button. Let's continue by doing a little housekeeping here. Text box 1, that name isn't very useful. We'll follow standard practice and change it from text box 1 to something more descriptive, such as input box, input text box. And we'll do the same thing for the other text box. We'll change that from input from text box 2 to output text box. And button 1, we'll do the same. We'll change that from button 1 to something more descriptive. In this case, we'll call it transfer button. We also want to change the text inside the button. So that's the text property for the button. If we slide down here in the properties window, we can see that button 1 is what it currently displays, and we'll just change that word entirely to transfer. Changing it here, we'll change it inside of the form. Now, the way that Visual Basic works is each one of these controls not only has several properties, they also have several methods, one of which is an event handler. So for instance, when the transfer button is pushed, that sets off an event, the click event for transfer button. And you can build then the code inside of an event handler that will be run whenever that button is pushed. The easiest way to get to that code is to double click on the button, which drops you inside of the code window. And it builds all of this code for you. This is the event handler for the transfer button click event. You see it here, it handles transfer button.click. Whenever that button is clicked, whatever code you write here will be run. And this is where we write the code to take the text from the input text box and put it into the output text box. We do that by saying output text box. and we want the text property of that box. We don't want the whole box itself, we just want the text that's inside of it. So we'll say dot text, and we'll set that equal to the text inside of the input text box, equals input text box dot text. And we also want to clear whatever is in the input text box. So we say input text box. And you may notice that Microsoft is being very helpful here in trying to suggest things that you might want to type. If you want, instead of typing, you can just click on these and it will type it for you. And you also see that when you type that dot, it shows you all of the properties that you could use, and also all of the methods that you can use. We're interested in the clear method. So I can either type clear, or I can just click it like that. And that will clear whatever is in the input text box after it's been transferred. And that's our program. To run the program, you click on the start button. It compiles it, puts up the form for you to try it. You're ready to type text into that first one. So we'll just type text to be transferred. Click the transfer button, and the text that was here now appears in the output text box, and whatever was in the input box has been cleared. And that's all there is to it.